The minister said this while presiding over, as the chief guest at the commissioning of 7 solar mini grid sites in the districts of Kasese and Rubirizi. This is aimed at extending power to rural areas that are not near the main grid. He said government is committed to ensuring that all communities that have not yet accessed power get it, while working hand in hand with development partners.
We will continue to work with these development partners to ensure access to financing for the future mini-grid development. We greatly appreciate the support offered by the local communities and local authorities to this project from its inception, and I call upon them to safeguard the installation passionately to curb the threat of vandalism.
Further condemned all wrongdoers who deal in vandalizing electricity equipment, calling them terrorists who do not want the country to develop.
Now, how do we call these people who do this vandalization? These are terrorists and crooks. They are murderers. You imagine, an operation is going on. You cut the tower. All the utilities are shut down. What have you done? You are a killer. Somebody dies at the bed, operation bed. You are a killer yourself, a terrorist. So if you are here, let me tell you that you don't like other people. If you are arrested, you should be in prison for life. There's no need to come to waste other people's time. I condemn these people very, very seriously.
The managing director for Worldwide Fund for Nature, David Dooley, revealed that so far 20 districts have been connected with the solar mini grid, adding that the target is to conserve the environment.
We are covering 20 districts. We have actually, let me say, covered 20 districts in this country. And I'm not going to go into the names, but these districts are located in the western arm of this country. That is called the Albertine Rift region of this country. Why? The Albertine Rift is the area in this in Africa and in the world that has the highest number of species, the highest numbers of endemic species, species that you can only find here, the highest diversity of ecosystems, ranging from 5,100 meters above sea level to 600 meters above sea level in the Semeliki Flats. So energy becomes an important aspect that coexists, its exploitation must coexist with these systems and with this diversity.
The LC5 Rubirizi district requested the Uganda Wildlife Authority to extend an electric wire to communities near Queen Elizabeth National Park to avoid wild animals crossing to communities.
So I would imagine that since the WWF has done this, we are going also to appeal to UWA to fence off the area. Once they are finished fencing, the communities or their gardens, they will also think of these communities who are living within the conclaves of the national park.
Wide Fund for Nature is targeting communities that are far from the national grid.
Story by Gilbert Muhanguzi for the news.